How does the biggest submarine in the US Navy operate? Submarines are ships capable of operating independently underwater. It differs from a submersible, which has a more limited ability to operate underwater. The term is also sometimes used historically to remotely controlled vehicles and robots. Civil uses include marine science, rescue, exploration, inspection, and facility maintenance. Submarines can also be modified for specialized missions, such as search and rescue missions, and repair of undersea cables. They are also used in tourism and underwater archaeology. Modern deep diving submarines are derived from the bathyscaphe, which evolved from diving bells. Want to know about it in detail? Well, stay tuned till the end. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we will talk about how the biggest submarine in the US Navy operates. Meanwhile, subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. That being done, let's start with a little introduction. The Ohio-class nuclear-powered submarines include 14 United States Navy ballistic missile submarines, SSBNs, and 4 cruise missile submarines, SSGN, with a displacement of 18,750 tons each. The Ohio-class ships are the largest submarines ever built for the United States Navy. They are the third largest submarine in the world, after the Soviet-designed 48,000-ton Typhoon-class and the 24,000-ton Bore-class. Ohio carries more missiles than both. 24 Trident II missiles each compared to 16 Bore-class missiles, 20 for the Bore-2-class, and 20 for the Typhoon-class. Like its predecessors, Benjamin Franklin and Lafayette-class submarines, Ohio's SSBNs are part of the US nuclear triad. Along with the US Air Force's strategic bombers and intercontinental ballistic missiles, the 14 SSBNs together carry out about half of the US operational strategic thermonuclear warheads. Although the Trident missiles do not have a defined target before the submarine goes on patrol, 392 can receive targets quickly from the U.S. Strategic Command base in Nebraska. Using the Secure and Continuous Radio Communication, INC, including very low-frequency systems, the lead submarine of this class is the USS Ohio. All Ohio-class submarines, except the USS Henry M. Jackson, are named for the U.S. states, where the previous U.S. Navy tradition was for battleships and cruisers. The Ohio-class will be gradually replaced by the Columbia-class starting in 2031. Ohio-class submarines are designed for extended strategic deterrence patrols. Each submarine is staffed with 2 full crews, known as the Blue Crew and the Yellow Crew, who typically conduct 70 to 90-day deterrence patrols. To reduce the time in port for crew turnover and resupply, 3 large logistics hatches were installed to provide large diameter resupply and repair capabilities. These hatches allow rapid transfer of supply pallets, replacement modules of equipment and machinery components, and speed up submarine resupply and maintenance. In addition, the stealth of the submarines has been significantly improved compared to all previous ballistic missile submarines. Ohio was virtually undetectable during sea trials in 1982, giving the US Navy extreme stealth that allows the boat to operate for about 15 years between major overhauls. These submarines will be as quiet at cruising speeds of 20 knots, 37 kilometers per hour, 23 miles per hour, or more as previous Lafayette-class submarines at 6 knots, 7 kilometers per hour, 6.9 miles per hour. Although the correct information is still stated in their Mark 48 torpedo fire control, was performed by the Mark 118 Mod 2 system, while the missile's fire control system was the Mark 98. Ohio-class submarines are built from hull sections, with each foredeck section measuring 42 feet 13 meters in diameter. Components are manufactured at General Dynamics Electric Boat's facility, Quonset Point, Rhode Island, and then assembled at the shipyard in Groton, Connecticut. The United States Navy has a total of 18 Ohio-class submarines, including 14 ballistic missile submarines, SSBNs, and 4 cruise missile submarines, SSGNs. SSBNs supply the maritime arm of the US nuclear triad. Each SSBN is armed with up to 24 Trident II submarine-launched ballistic missiles, SLBMs. Each SSGN is capable of carrying up to 154 Tomahawk cruise missiles, plus an additional Harpoon missile fired through their torpedo tubes. As part of the new START treaty, 4 tubes per SSBN will be disabled, leaving each ship with only 20 tubes available for war payloads. So what are your thoughts on this? Let us know in the comments below. And that's all for the day, guys. If you found this video interesting, make sure to hit the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update from us. Thank you for watching. We'll see you at the next one. Until then, peace.